Welcome everyone, my name is Pramod Beesal. I am an IIT Delhi graduate and currently an IRSME officer. In this video, we are going to discuss about the velocity analysis and velocity diagrams. The previous year questions that has been asked in GATE right from 2010 till 2019. Okay, so all the questions which are related with velocity diagram, we are going to discuss them here. And as I told you in previous parts also, that you can solve these same questions with the help of I-center analysis also. And I-center analysis as well as the velocity diagram, both diagrams will be similar, so the amount of calculation is going to be similar in both cases. So it depends on you whether you want to use the I-centers or you want to use the velocity diagram approach. Fine. Now let's look at the question that was asked in 2010, and it says, for the configuration shown below, this is the configuration of the mechanism. The angular velocity of AB is 10 radian per second. Okay, the angular velocity of AB is 10 radian per second counterclockwise. Magnitude of relative sliding velocity in meter per second of the slider B. So we have a slider B here which is sliding on link CD. Okay, so there is a link CD and B can slide over that particular link. With respect to link CD is what we need to calculate that. Okay, and the things that we are already given, AB length is given as 250 mm, means the crank length is 250 mm, and this angle is 90 degrees. So the instant at which we need to calculate the values is such that they are making 90 degrees with other and 60 degrees with the horizontal. Now when you look at these questions, two cases, the angles 90 degrees and angles 45 degrees are mostly asked, and they are very simple. Okay, once the angle becomes 90 degree, it makes our calculation very very simple. Okay, so let's see what will happen here. So in order to solve that, I am going to make the velocity diagram here, right? So as we have been doing in previous questions also, in previous parts we have already seen it. So let's say this is my origin for the velocity diagram. Okay, I need to assign point as a reference, point A and point C, which are having zero velocities, right? Now when I say velocity of point B, I can say velocity of point A, point B is on the slider but it is associated with link AB. Okay, so velocity of A plus velocity of B with respect to A. Now velocity of A is what? Zero. And B with respect to A will be what? Omega of this link BA into the link length of BA, right? And it is going to be perpendicular to our AB link. Okay, so if this is my AB link, its velocity is going to be perpendicular to this link, right? So it is going to make a 90 degrees angle with this. So I can say there will be 30 degrees in here. That will be my velocity of point B with respect to A. Okay, so when I represent it here, it will be something like this. Okay, so that is going to be my point B and this is going to be my velocity of point B, right? If I want to calculate the value, I can always calculate it. Omega value is given as 10 and AB length is given as 250 mm. Okay, so that comes out to be 2.5 meter per second. Clear? Now that is about the velocity B, but we don't need to calculate the velocity B. We need the velocity of slider with respect to link CD. Okay, now how exactly will we do that? So the second thing that I can do, that velocity of point D, okay, there is a point D that is on the slider but with respect to link CD. Okay, so velocity of D is equal to velocity of C plus D with respect to C, right? That sort of analysis we do, and VC is a fixed point, so that is zero, and DC will be omega of CD, whatever is the omega of that particular link, into CD length, and that will be perpendicular to the CD link. Okay, so I'm having my CD link here which is at an angle of 30 degrees, so it is going to be perpendicular to it. That will be velocity of CD, right? Making an angle 60 degree. So let's denote it here first. So my D point should lie along this line. Somewhere along this line my D point should lie. Okay, but I don't know the exact point, so I will need to take another reference. Another reference, what we can take? Point B, because B and D are with are in contact with each other, right? So I will say VD is equal to VB plus VD with respect to B. That is important here, D with respect to B. Now VB, I already know that is the point here. Okay, then VD with respect to B. Now D with respect to B will be a sliding velocity. Okay, it is going to be sliding velocity, so it will be along link CD. Okay, slider can move along the link or along the slot on which it is mounted, right? So that is going to be my velocity of d with respect to b, right? So d with respect to b will be having, will be along this angle only. So that angle that I had made earlier, 30 degree, so it is going to be along that angle only. Okay, so that is going to give me, same line will be also applicable for d. So where are these two intersecting with each other? That is our common point. So d point will also lie here. Okay, so now I have calculated all my points of the links. Okay, I have calculated all the velocities, but what I need exactly, I need the slider velocity with respect to link cd, right? Now when I say the slider velocity with respect to link cd, means I need to calculate vd with respect to b. And what is vd with respect to b? This length. Okay, that is my length, which is the relative velocity between my slider b and the link cd. Okay, so what is that going to be? The velocity of b with respect to d, if I talk in numerals only, then it will be equal to vb only, right? And vb I have already calculated as 2.5 meter per second. So that is going to be our answer. Now in most of the solutions that you see, you may directly find that they have given that the velocity of the slider will be equal to directly r into omega. Okay, but that comes from here only, and that is true only for a 90 degree angle here. If the angle was not 90 degree, this analysis would have been incorrect. Okay, so that you have to be very careful about. Had they changed the angle, this line would have been changed and our point D would have come somewhere here or at some other point. Okay, so that will not be always true. That will be true only if this angle is 90 degree here. Okay, so be careful about such solutions whenever you see. Now second question asked in 2011, it says 4 bar linkage is shown, angular velocity of AB is 1 radian per second, AB angular velocity is given, the length of CD is 1.5 times the length of AB. Okay, so CD is equal to 1.5 times length of AB. And the angular velocity of CD will be what? Omega CD will be what? So I also mentioned this in our previous video, that this particular configuration has been asked repeatedly in GATE, and it is very, very important configuration when both these angles become 90 degrees, right? So that configuration is very important. Well, I'm going to make the velocity diagram here if you haven't watched the previous video, for that purpose only. Okay, so this is my center, that will be point A and point D origin. Okay, now when I say velocity of point B, so that will be perpendicular to this link, right? And velocity of B is equal to velocity of A plus velocity of B with respect to A, that is 0, and this comes out to be omega of AB into link length AB, right? Now I don't know what is the link length here, so I will simply say omega into AB, omega of AB into the length AB. I don't know what is it exactly. So let's say it is coming to some distance here. This is my point B. Okay, now when I talk about point C, I can say velocity of C is equal to velocity of D plus velocity of C with respect to D, means it is going to be perpendicular to this link, right? And that gives me that it is going to lie on this line only. So C will be either on this side or on this side, depending upon our relative velocity. Okay, so second reference that I use for C will be B, right? So VB plus VC with respect to B, and that gives me, at B I need to add this particular relative velocity, and that will be perpendicular to BC. Now again, you can say that we don't know the angles here. You don't need to know the angle, because that will not be used here. Okay, so that will ultimately will become, let's say, perpendicular to BC. Okay, I'm simply making a line here perpendicular to BC. So C point is lying on this line and C point is lying on this line. Intersection is this only, common point here. Okay, so finally what we get? We get VB is equal to VC. Now after getting this, I mentioned this earlier also, that most people will say that omega of CD will be equal to that of B, and they will put 1 as their answer. But that will be incorrect, because it is velocity, not angular velocity. We need to convert it into angular velocity. Okay, so I will say VB is equal to what? Omega AB into length AB is equal to, VC is equal to what? Omega CD into length CD. Clear? Very simple formulation that we can write over here. Okay, we are already given that CD is equal to 1.5 times AB. Okay, so CD is equal to 1.5 times AB. So omega AB is equal to omega CD into 1.5 times. right? So finally omega cd comes out to be 2 divided by 3 radian per second. Okay, don't make this mistake. Don't put one here. Answer will be about 2 by 3 radians per second. Okay, now I'm going to make it a little faster. This is a question wherein a rigid link PQ, there is a rigid link PQ given in our question. Okay, so this is point P and this is point Q and the link is rigid. Magnitude of VP for the given instantaneous direction. So magnitude of VP we need to calculate for the given condition set. Okay, the PQ length is given to me as 2 meter. Okay, we will not even requiring the length here that you will realize soon, right? So let's make the velocity diagram here and see how exactly we are going to do it. Okay, so when I make the velocity diagram, how exactly will it look like? So this is again going to be my origin. Okay, origin means whatever the point which is having a zero velocity. There is no point here which I can define a zero velocity point, so I will simply say O. Then I need to put VP on this. So somewhere along this line is our VP, because direction is already mentioned. That's why I don't know the point. I don't know the point of VP because I don't know the magnitude here, right? But VQ, I know the magnitude and I know its angle also. That is given to me as 45 degrees, right? So at 45 degrees, I am having my VQ as 1 meter per second, right? And for VP, next information that I have is VQ plus VP with respect to Q, right? And that will be perpendicular to PQ. So perpendicular to PQ means perpendicular to PQ. So this angle is going to be how much? 70 degrees. So that is the line of PQ. Okay. So I will simply add this line here. Okay. That can be added over here. That will be angle of 70 degrees because that is what we have over here. Okay. Now I can apply the simple law of sine rule. I can put here, so VPQ, that is this length divided by sine 45, is equal to VQ divided by sine 70, and that is equal to VP divided by sine 90, right? This will be 90 degrees over, sorry, no, not 90, we will calculate it. 70 degrees, 45 degrees, so how much will this remain? I think 65 degrees. Okay, so that will become sine of 65 degrees. Clear? Now we needed to calculate what? We needed to calculate the magnitude of VP. So we will use these two equations. So VP is equal to nothing but VQ into sine 65 divided by sine 70. Okay, I will put all the values here. VQ is given to me as 1 into sine 65 and 75. I can calculate with our calculator and that will come out to be 0.96 meter per second. Okay, so that is our answer for this particular case. So you see, the questions are very simple. They can be solved in a single step or at max 2 steps only. Okay, so don't worry about those questions. Now the next question that we had in 2016, it is a theoretical question basically, and it says there is a rigid link PQ undergoing a plane motion as shown. So this is a link PQ. There are two velocity directions here, P and Q. Now VP and VQ are both non-zero. Now VQP, the relative velocity of point Q with respect to point P, will be what? Okay, so we have done so many questions based upon these relative velocity and so many things here. So we already know that I can say VQP is equal to what? VQ minus VP. Okay, and I can also say that this comes out to be equal to what? VQP into the length QP, and it is perpendicular to QP, right? All these things are true. We have already discussed them. So let's see the options. VQP has components along and perpendicular to PQ. Does it have any component perpendicular to PQ? No. Along PQ? No component along PQ. VQP has only one component from P to Q. Is it having any component along PQ line? No, it is not having any component. VQP has only one component along Q to P. So that is also not correct. And VQP has only one component perpendicular to PQ. So that is right. There is only one component and that is perpendicular to QP. Right? Very simple questions. Very simple questions. Now this question had a little bit of calculations. So just be vigilant, a little bit vigilant while I'm watching this. But rod AB, there is a rod AB here. Okay, of length 1 meter. The total length of the rod is given to me as 1 meter, connected to two cylinders at each end. There are two cylinders, cylinder A and cylinder B. If VA is 2 meter per second, VA is given to me as 2 meter per second, velocity of the midpoint of rod AB. On rod AB, if I define some midpoint D, then what will be the velocity of that particular point at the given instant? Okay, so I'm given an instant here. The instant is such that VA is equal to 2 meter per second and the angles are 60 and 60. So ultimately this will also become 60. It will become a similar triangle, right? So I need to calculate VD. Now the mistake that you can make here is you, while doing the calculation, you will get VB, okay, and you will also get VBA. So either you will put this as your answer or you will put this as your answer and you will not go to VD because you are in hurry. Okay, you don't exactly remember what was asked in question and you will simply do your calculation that you are habitual of and you will put the wrong answer there. So just be careful regarding that thing. Okay, fine. Let's make the velocity diagram here and see what will be the answer. Okay, so in order to make the velocity diagram, the very first thing that I need to do is take an origin, of course, point which is having a zero velocity. I don't have any point in my system, so I will simply say O is having a zero velocity. Fine. Now I already know that there is a VA which is at an angle of 60 degrees, right? So at 60 degrees angle, I am having my VP. So this is my VP and that, VA. VA which is equal to 2 meter per second and this is point A. Okay. Now, the second thing I already know that B is going to move along this direction only, right? So on the velocity diagram also, B should lie either on this side or on this side, whichever side. Okay. I don't know which side it will be. It will be lying on this particular line. That is the line of B. Okay. Now, in order to establish the exact location, what I do, VB is equal to VA plus VB with respect to A. Okay. And B with VA, I already know in that VA, I need to add this B with respect to A. And B with respect to A is what? Omega of AB into AB and perpendicular to AB, right? That is what is going to happen here. So AB perpendicular to AB, there is going to be a line perpendicular to AB, so it is going to make an angle of 30 degrees, right? That is my AB line, correct? No confusion till here. Okay, so at this location, now since this angle was 60 degrees, right, I need to make an angle of 30 degrees. Here you need to be very careful, and then this will be the line of B. Somewhere on this line, my point B will be lying. Okay, so when these two lines are intersecting each other, that will become my B point. Okay, so this is the final VB velocity and this is my VAB. Okay, this particular length is VAB. But what I needed to calculate, okay, just see here that this angle is 30 degrees. This angle is, how much will it be? 120 degrees, because it is 60 degrees. So it will become automatically 120 degrees. And this will become how much? 30 degrees. Again, similar triangle concept. Okay, so it will be 30 degrees. Now I can say that VAB divided by sine 120 is equal to VB divided by sine 30 is equal to VA divided by sine 30. Sine rule, simple sine rule, right? From here I can say that VAB is equal to how much? VAB, I can put these two equal to each other. So VA, that is 2 into sine 120 divided by sine 130. Sine 30 is what? 1 by 2. And sine 120 can be given as cos 30. And cos 30 is what? Root 3 by 2. So it comes out to be 2 root 3 meter per second. That is my velocity of A with respect to B. Okay. What I needed to calculate the velocity of point D, which is at the midpoint. Okay. How exactly do I relate that? So whatever is link here, that is link AB, I can locate that link here in my diagram. That is my link AB, right? And I need its midpoint. So I will go to its midsection. That is my point D. And this velocity I need to calculate. Okay, I have already discussed this thing in our previous video. So this OD is the velocity of point D, right? I can now calculate OD distance. How? How exactly will I calculate the OD distance? I will use the vector summation here. Okay, this length I know is root 3 because total was 2 root 3. So half length will be root 3. This length I know is 2 and I know the angle between these two is 30 degrees. Okay, so OD square will be equal to OA square plus AD square minus 2 into OA into AD into cos angle between them, that is 30 degrees. Okay, now I will put all the values in here. So it will become OA square will be how much? 4 plus AD square will be 3 minus 2 into OA is 2, AD is root 3 and cos 30 is root 3 by 2. And if you solve this whole, this will become 1. Then OD is equal to 1 meter per second. That is our final answer. Okay. The velocity of the midpoint is 1 meter per second. We can calculate all other velocities also. Like if we need to calculate the angular velocity, then that can be given as VAB is equal to omega AB into the length AB, that was 1 meter, so that will be our angular velocity. And the velocity of point B also we can calculate, since it is a similar triangle, the velocity of B is equal to be velocity of A. Okay, so all those things are very easily calculatable in this particular case.